गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमम् येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनशृण्वन्नूतिभिद्दीदसादनम् ॐ श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः ॐ वृषभं शर्षणीनां विश्वरूपमदाभ्यम् बृहस्पतिं वरेण्यम् ॐ तद्विष्णोः परमं पदं सदा पश्यन्ति सूरय दिवि वचक्षुरातम् ॐ ऐं ह्रीं श्रीं क्लीं हसौ जगत्प्रसूत्यै नमः. एवरीबडी से हरे राम कृष्णा थ्री टाइम्स आफ्टर मी. ॐ हरे राम कृष्ण हरे राम कृष्ण हरे राम कृष्ण. दोज ऑफ यू हु मिस द नारायण दशा द फर्स्ट क्लास ऑन नारायण दशा विच बेसिकली मीन्स श्रीराम लिसन टू द ऑडियो. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द दशा देयर बट द बॉटम लाइन इज इवन इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू कंप्यूट इट It's not really a big deal because you have the software that can do it for you. So you can use the software to do the calculations. So it's not a big deal. But the important point is to know how to interpret the dasa. So I gave three different principles, three different basic philosophies for interpreting the Narayan dasa. And the first one is to see the dasa sign itself. Suppose somebody is running SG dasa, Sagittarius dasa. See what house Sagittarius is in the chart. And what planets are there, which house laws are there. So all those will be activated at that time. Basically, Narayana will be present in that house during that time of somebody's life. So that is one way to interpret it. And the second way is, take the dasa sign as the lagna. If Narayana dasa has been progressed from lagna, then take the dasa sign as lagna. If Narayana dasa has been progressed from the seventh house, that means the dasa sign is the progressed seventh house. So take the seventh from it, that will be the lagna, progress lagna. So use the progress lagna as the reference and judge the natal chart. Take the same chart, but lagna will change. At birth, lagna was in Pisces. For example, if somebody is born right now, at birth, lagna is in Pisces. But after some time, it will become Cancer. After some time, it will become Scorpio. Like that, it will keep progressing. And take the dasa sign or the seventh from it as lagna and then analyze. 10th lord is in the 8th house. So during this dasa, there will be some disturbances in career. There will be some instability in career. Or let's say 10th lord is in the 11th house. So career will be good and he will make a lot of money during this dasa. Like that, you can judge taking that sign as the lagna and judge the Narayana dasa. And finally, the final principle that I explained is the most important one, especially when you want to judge the antardasas. The principle I explained is, if you want to judge a particular dasha, the antardashas within it, you want to see how all these 12 antardashas will be, look at the dasha pravesha chakra, the entry chart of the period. Click the button on it and then click on this entry chart of this period, and in this entry chart, see how each house is. For example, if you see, let's take this hypothetical example. Why should we take hypothetical example? Let's take a real example. Let us take my chart. PVR Narasimha Rao. The data is April 4, 1970, 5:47:13 PM, Indian Standard Time, Machilipatnam, India, 81 East 8, 16 North 10. Okay. So let us take the Narayana dasa. Let us say we are interested in Sagittarius Narayana dasa. So, pardon me? You have a question?
No, over it is 1995.
Yeah, it's over. We are usually interested in things that are over so that we can learn, rather than things that are yet to come. So take the Sagittarius dasa and let us say entry chart of this period. Okay? Now, this dasa started in 1985 on April 4 at this time, 1:57:02 PM. And it will go on till 1995, April 5, 3:25:45 AM. It went on till that day. So this is the duration. These 10 years is the duration of this dasa. and these are the individual antardashas. Okay, now if you want to look at the Sagittarius antardasha, suppose we want to see how Sagittarius antardasha within Sagittarius Mahadasha would be. Suppose that is what we want to do. Then, yes.
In the empty chart, the resonance doesn't start from the Sagittarius.
No, it doesn't. At the time the dasha started,
at that point
if you go to Machilipatnam, if you look at the east, it may be Capricorn, it may be Cancer, anything may be rising. So assuming that at the exact time when the dasha started for me, assuming that a small kid was born, a baby was born in my mother tongue, in my birthplace, you are casting the chart of that boy, basically. You understand? So the dasha is starting for me, let us say, right now. So right now, if a baby is born in my birthplace, not where I am living, but in my birthplace, if a baby is born, how the life of that baby will be has some correlation with how my life will be during that particular dasha. If I am running a 10-year dasha, during those 10 years, there will be some similarities between my life and the life of a baby who was born just now. Because it is like I am starting a new existence. When a new dasha is starting, it is like it's a new existence. It's a new entity that's starting. PVR Narasimha Rao's life during Sagittarius dasha is a particular entity that just took birth at that particular time. So if you make the chart, the lagna may be something else. It doesn't have to be Sagittarius. But that will be the same lagna which that baby will have. If a baby is born.
Cancer,
yes. Okay? So what you do is, taking Cancer as lagna, see how various dasas are. See what is the relative placement. For example, let us take Sagittarius dasa. Is it Sagittarius under dasa? Is Sagittarius good or bad in this particular chart?
Not
good.
Sixth house
is a Dusthana. But where is this Lord?
Seventh.
He is in Nicha. He is debilitated. If the sixth Lord is debilitated, or eighth Lord is debilitated, or twelfth Lord is debilitated, is it good or bad?
It's good.
It's good. In particular, there is a yoga called Jaya Yoga. Jaya means victory. So this is a yoga that makes somebody victorious. I think I mentioned it earlier. Sixth Lord being in Nicha and tenth Lord being in Uccha. That is Jaya Yoga. Tenth is basically your achievement. And sixth is the process of overcoming enemies. So if the sixth Lord is debilitated and the tenth Lord is exalted, that is Jaya Yoga. Sometimes you see that in some charts, the tenth Lord may not be actually exalted, but he may be strong. He may be in Om sign or Mola Trikona. Still you will have the results of Jaya Yoga. Basically, sixth law should be weak and tenth law should be strong. Then that gives Jaya Yoga.
The yoga.
Jaya means victory. So it gives victory over enemy. Suppose somebody is fighting a court case for a long time. When that antardasha giving Jaya Yoga comes, suddenly he will win. Or if somebody is going for a competitive examination, he will do very well. Basically, sixth law being in Nicha means his enemies being depressed. That's what it means. Sixth Lord is your enemies. And Nicha means they are depressed, they are sad. Your enemies are sad, which means you win. So that is what that means. So, or let us say there is a political leader who has Jaya Yoga in his chart. And let us say the corresponding dasha has just come. So that will be a great period for that person. The person will win and his enemies will lose. Let me throw up an example of Jaya Yoga.
Only seen from lagna?
Yes, it's only seen from lagna. Jaya Yoga is seen only from lagna, not from Aruha lagna or Chandra lagna, other lagna. Now, I have to change the font again because I did not close it. So, I did not save the settings. Let us take the chart of our beloved President George W. Bush. Let us take his dashamsa. Does anybody see that there is Jaya Yoga in the Dashamsa?
Yes.
Why?
Because the sixth Lord is in
seventh. Sixth Lord Jupiter is in seventh house, is in Nicha. And what about the tenth Lord?
Exalted.
Tenth Lord Mars is?
Exalted.
So the tenth Lord is exalted and the sixth Lord is debilitated. So he has Jaya Yoga. The combination is there without any modifications. If Mars was not exalted, but had he been in one house, still we would have said Templar D is strong, he is in one house. So Jaya Yoga is basically present, though not in its purest form. Here the Templar D is exalted also. So Jaya Yoga is clearly there. So what do you expect for him? You expect victory during Jupiter Dasha or Mars Dasha. When Jupiter or Mars periods come, he will be victorious over his enemy. And do you know what Dasha he is running right now? First of all, tell me what Dasha should we apply for him?
Narayan.
Forget Narayan. I'm going back to the Nakshatra Dasha. Oh, okay. Because I'm talking about Jupiter and Mars now. I want to see when the result of Jaya Yoga will be given. So I want to see when Jupiter Dasha comes or Mars Dasha comes. So I'm going back to the planet Dasha.
V
Saptadi Samadasa. Good. Why? Yes. Seventh Lord Saturn. Seventh house is Capricorn. The Lord is Saturn. He is in Lagna. So Vimshottari may be applied, but the best is V Saptadi Samadasa. If you go to V Saptadi Samadasa, what dasa is he running? From April 2000 till April 2009, this gentleman is running Jupiter Dasha. So, there will be ups and downs, but overall these 9 years are a very good period in career. This is a period in which his enemies will be depressed. His enemies in career, which is basically Jupiter, they will be depressed during this time. He will give lot of sorrow to his enemies. They will be disappointed. He will be victorious during this dasha. And it was around April 2000 that his victory started. Until then, he was one of the contenders, and then suddenly John McCain, who was leading in the primaries, he fell down, and George Bush picked up around that time frame, March-April time frame in 2000. That's when he started. Originally, in a few states, in New Hampshire and a couple of states, John McCain did well, and then George Bush came from behind, and he took the lead, and that was around the time when this particular dasha started. And he will go out of office in 2009, January. So this whole period, these two terms, he is running Jupiter Dasha. So this is Jaya Yoga. And if you look at this Dasha Pravesha Chakra, there is a Jaya Yoga given by Sagittarius Lord Jupiter and Aries Lord Mars. So one of those two Dashas, Aries or Sagittarius, they can give the result of that Jaya Yoga.
So Mars is in his own house, but he's afflicted.
Yes, he's afflicted. Yes.
So that won't give you a day. The strength is not that strong.
That's strong. So 60 is more likely to give the result than 10. Very good, very good. So if you look at the Sagittarius Antardasha, that ran from 1986 December till 1987 October. I showed George Bush chart just to show an example of Jaya Yoga in the natal chart. And here we are talking about Jaya Yoga in the Dasha Pravesha Chakra. So that result of the Jaya Yoga, the partial Jaya Yoga, will be given in Sagittarius Antardasha. So that Antardasha is between 1986 and 1987. So it was exactly during that time, in 87 May, that I was selected for IIT. And I was state first in my state in intermediate examinations. So all those things happened during that particular dasha, that particular antardasha. Can anyone tell me how would be Aquarius antardasha? If you don't get biased. With any expectations, if you just look at this chart, what do you expect in Aquarius Dasha, Aquarius Antardasha, which is from 1988 August till 1989 June?
First of all, 9,000 Dharma.
9,000 from where? Aquarius. Which Lagna? Whose Lagna? Ascendant is Cancer. And we are looking at Aquarius. So we are looking at Aquarius. How will be Aquarius Antardasha?
8th house.
Is the 8th house?
Of the 8th house, Saturn will be sitting. He will be sitting in the 5th house.
Yeah.
Rahu is also the Lord, and he's sitting in the 10th house.
Yeah. First, tell me one thing. Is it a good antardasha or bad antardasha?
I cannot do bad.
Okay. Why do you say it's bad?
I don't know, because if I look at the Lord Rahu,
yeah,
He's in your 10th house. So
yeah.
So if you're taking the, of course, the long-term problems, but he's working in the 10th house.
Basically, 8th house means working hard.
Working hard.
Yeah. He's working hard during that time, right? Who is he with? Who is the Lord with?
One is with Mars.
Yeah, one is with Mars, the 10th Lord in the 10th house.
And the other one actually is in your 5th house of abilities.
Yeah.
And he's with Arudha Lagna. So it actually could be good. I don't see why it's bad.
He is with Ghatika Lagna, Hora Lagna, and he's aspecting Lagna. Any planet associating with Lagna, Ghatika Lagna, and Hora Lagna, I told you earlier, is a Yogada. So Saturn is a Yogada. One of the lords is a Yogada. The other lord is afflicting Mars, but one of the lords is a Yogada. So, in studies, because I was a student at that time, I was doing BTech at IIT Madras. Do you think I would have done well in studies or not?
Yes,
I would have done well because one lord is with Mars. I was doing electronics engineering, which is what Mars and Rahu show, and I was preparing for a career. So one lord is in the 10th house, even though he's 8th lord of working hard. He's in a Kendra with that Kendra lord with Mars. The other lord is in the 5th house of recognition. 5th house is always, it shows recognition of abilities. And that too, Arudha Lagna is there.
Is it
A9
there?
Here? Yeah, it is A9. It is A9, yeah. Bhagyabada and Arudha Lagna. So, for me?
What I understand is, 8th lord gives anxiety. His agenda is to give anxiety.
Uh-huh.
So if he is in 10th house, he will give anxiety in career.
Yeah.
Then same as Saturn.
Yeah.
He should give anxiety over the activities. So what is the agenda? We went with agenda. We go with agenda, or what is?
Okay, that is a good point. Basically, being the 8th lord, they have to give some anxiety, but it's not just anxiety. The 8th house is hard work and anxiety. 8th house does not necessarily need to show anxiety. It can also show working hard, basically.
Okay.
Right? Both are very associated concepts. So 8th lord's agenda is to make the person struggle, or to make the person work hard, to make the person not be peaceful, basically, not be relaxed. He doesn't, 8th lord does not want you to happily relax and enjoy life. He wants you to do something, keep doing something. That is 8th lord's agenda.
But I also thought 8th lord is unexpected trouble.
It can be trouble or it can be good also. But 8th lord gives sudden developments. 8th house is some kind of, it gives that kind of reaction. When it happens, you're surprised. You didn't expect it. So 8th lord shows unexpected things. 8th lord shows digging hidden things. 8th house also shows hidden things. So pursuing hidden things. And he also shows some kind of anxiety and tension. He also shows working hard intentionally. He can show any of these things. But if you don't want to do any of these things, if you just want to relax in your house and just watch TV throughout the day, if you want to do that, he will not like it. Then he will give you a disease or something. He will give you some problem or the other, something that will make you work. Not
if
relax.
You work hard, you counteract it.
If you work hard, you are basically already doing that. So 8th lord is happy. His agenda is being taken care of. If you don't want to do that, he will give you. He will make you do that. That is the 8th lord. So 8 is not necessarily anxiety. That is only one aspect of it. And here basically 8th lord, he did not make me sit idle. He made me study. He made me work hard towards those particular goals.
Yes.
Towards 10th house and towards 5th house. And especially Saturn being in Ghatika Lagna also. He's in the 5th house from Lagna and he's in Ghatika Lagna. Arudha Lagna is there. So, I should do well in studies. And as a matter of fact, during that particular Antardasa, I jumped to the first rank in my class. Until then, I was in the bottom half. In my first year, I took things very easy. But in the second year, my second year at IIT Madras, I did well. And I jumped to the first rank. Based on the CGPA, cumulative GPA for the first 2 years. I compensated for an average first year in the second year, and I became class first. So, that is shown by Saturn, the Antardasa Lord, being in the 5th house. And if you look at Pisces, how will Pisces be? Yes?
Do we have to take Sagittarius reference at all?
No. You don't have to take Sagittarius as reference at all. When you are judging Antardasas, just look at the Lagna rising at the time Dasha started.
Okay.
That is your reference. then only you will get good results. This is what I found working in practice, and that is why there are so many other ways of judging Narayan Dasa, but I am not going into all those because this works very well.
That we have to see the natal chart. Natal chart, we have to see the Sagittarius and aspects Lagna and all those things.
Right. In the natal chart, you can take Sagittarius or Lagna, and you can say, see, for example, let us go back to the natal chart. We are looking at Sagittarius Dasa, and we are looking at, let us say, Aquarius Antar Dasa. Okay? If you take Sagittarius as Lagna, actually, should you take Sagittarius as Lagna? The Dasas, if you remember, Lagna is empty and 7th house is having one planet. So, 7th is stronger. So, we started from 7th house. So in Sagittarius Dasa, Gemini will become the Lagna. So you take Gemini as Lagna, and now if you look at various Antar Dasas, look at Sagittarius Antar Dasa. Sagittarius is the 7th house from Gemini. Now we are taking Gemini as Lagna, remember that. During this Dasa, to judge various Antar Dasas, we are taking Gemini as Lagna. Now, if you take the Sagittarius Antar Dasa, which is from 87 December to October 87. During that period, the Lord Jupiter, he is in the 5th house of recognition of abilities. So, based on this, you can expect that there will be some recognition of abilities. And if you know that this particular child or this particular person, he is going to appear for engineering entrance examinations, etc. during the year, looking at Jupiter in the 5th house, we can conclude that he will do a very good job. My father told me, don't write engineering entrance examination. I wanted to write. There is an exam called MCET, EAMCET, Engineering and Medical Common Entrance Test, which is a popular exam in Andhra Pradesh state. My father said, don't write. Why do you want to waste my money? You will get IIT. Just write IIT JE. You will go to IIT. Don't waste my money by applying for other exams. Not that he wanted to save money, but he said, don't. There is no need. You will get it. Don't worry about it. So that was the level of confidence he had. If somebody comes to you and asks you, Should I take 10 exams or should I just take a couple of exams? You can give them confidence. If you see a combination like this, you can be confident that the person will do well during a particular year. On the other hand, if you don't see a good combination, then you have to worry. Then you have to tell them, maybe give them a few mantras to increase the chances, or tell the parents to have some backup plans, because what they are banking on may or may not come through. So anyway, coming back to the dasha, if you want to see Pisces Antar Dasa, for example, let us say Taurus Antar Dasa. I want to see what happened in 1991. If you take Taurus Antar Dasa, what are the possibilities? Just based on the natal chart. Taking Gemini as Lagna, Taurus is the 12th house. So will it be an Antar Dasa of losses? Yeah, possible, quite possible. Or could it be the Antar Dasa of displacement from the motherland? Yeah, 12th house can show that also. It can be losses or it can be going abroad. Especially the 12th Lord Venus, he is associating with 9th Lord Shani also. And he is in the house of gains. Even though Taurus is the 12th house, its Lord, he is in the house of gains. So it's probably not a loss, but it's probably losing something to gain something else. So, it was a displacement from the motherland, but it was a profitable displacement. I came to, during that Antar Dasa, in 91 August, I came to Rice University in Houston, and I came with a fellowship of $1,000, which is a lot of money for a student. I didn't have to help in any research or any teaching. I wasn't a teaching assistant or research assistant. I didn't have to do anything. They just give me $1,050 fellowship every month. So, I came to US with a gain. There was a gain in it, but there was a displacement. I was displaced from where I came from my birthplace. So 12th house can show losses, but remember that it can also be good losses. 12th house can also show, if you are talking about spiritual things, it can show spiritual experiences like Kundalini rising, etc. 8th and 12th houses will be active at such kind of events. So 12th house can show those positive events relating to moksha, relating to spirituality. It can show going to a foreign place, settling down in a foreign place, etc. So there are so many possibilities, but definitely going abroad gainfully is a considerable possibility based on natal chart. If you look at the Narayan Dasa and Antar Dasa and you judge it based on natal chart, it is possible. Now let us see the... Yes.
Yes. we need to see the like way we see in the regular dashas, nakshatra dashas, like Bhoga and Pata. Same thing we have to see.
There are associated principles, it's not the same.
Okay.
There are similar principles, we'll talk about them later.
Okay.
Because even without using them, you can give a lot of good reading.
Okay.
So let us just stick to the basics that I taught in the first class and see a few examples. So now, look at this Dasha Pravesha Chakra, the entry chart. So when the Sagittarius Dasha started, this is the chart. So if you want to judge what happened in Taurus and the Dasha.
11th house in this case.
Yes. Taurus is the 11th house of?
Kings.
So overall, will it be a good Antar Dasha or bad Antar Dasha? It will be a good Antar Dasha. There will be gains. And where is the Lord? Lord Venus?
In the 9th house.
He is in the 9th house. Ninth house of Dharma. So it can be gains through Dharma. Also ninth house can also show going abroad. 9th and 12th. These are the houses for traveling abroad. So it is the 11th house. There is another point that I told you. What are the factors that I told you about foreign journey? 9th, 12th, and there is a third factor I told you. Anybody remember? Pardon me? Sahamam, fine. But something else I told you. What about Bhadaka? I told you that Bhadakasthana has a lot to do with taking a person abroad.
Yeah.
So when you are looking at displacement, look for Bhadaka, look for 9th Lord and look for 12th Lord. Those are the indications. And here, does anybody note that Taurus is also Bhadakasthana? It is the house of gains, but it is also Bhadakasthana. So it is Bhadakasthana, its Lord is exalted in the 9th house and its Lord joins Mercury, who is the 12th Lord. So its Lord is in the 9th house along with 12th Lord. So all the influences, Bhadaka, 9th and 12th came together in the 9th house. So either Pisces Antar Dasha or Taurus Antar Dasha have a very good chance of taking the person abroad. And that indeed happened. So during that particular Antar Dasha, I went abroad. I came to US for my master's. Now, let us, instead of looking at my example, I want to give you an example that somebody posted as a puzzle on Vedic Astrology Yahoo group. Those of you who already know the answer, this is a puzzle by somebody named Vikram Singhvi from California. He gave his chart, something very important, some big event happened in his life in the last week, and he wanted to see if anybody can guess it without knowing any more details about it. And actually one person did guess it correctly, but he guessed it based on Prashna, not based on the natal chart. And I want to see if you guys can come close. So I'll give you a puzzle, just give it your best shot without worrying about being correct or not. And if anybody knows the answer, did you see the mail? Yeah, if you know the answer,
yes.
Just keep quiet.
Sure.
Don't participate. Also don't give hints.
No. I understand.
Okay, good.
I also saw the I had analyzed it in Prasanna in a different way. Yeah, your analysis was there too for the same event.
No, not for this.
Yeah, I remember seeing your analysis for a different
purpose.
Yeah. And in general, it's a good idea to join Vedic Astrology Yahoo group. And from time to time, people will be giving puzzles without telling you what the event is, without telling you the background. Basically, you have to guess the background, guess the event, just based on the chart and maybe a few past events for the explanation. So it will be fun. You may go wrong, but it doesn't matter. What matters is you have to learn.
See,
and you will learn.
Going through the books, that point of time, you know, some basic.
Yeah. It's a very good idea to try those puzzles. That's the best way to learn. Okay, the data is, this is from Vedic Astrology Yahoo group, this data. April 7, 1970, 6:11 a.m. I just entered the data before I came. I was in a rush. I don't know if I made any mistake. Yeah, 6:11 a.m. Okay. April 7, 1970, 6:11 a.m. Indian Standard Time. And the place, I don't know what the place is. He did not mention it. It's 73 East 40, 26 North 40. Is that right? 73 East 40, 26 North 40. In case anybody wants to read the whole mail, the mail is here. But the summary is, a devastating event happened in the life of this native during on last Tuesday, I think. The background was building for the last 2 weeks, and finally it happened on Tuesday. All the good events of my life have happened on Tuesday, so very surprised to surprise how this thing has happened on Tuesday. Okay, and what's the course of future action? He is also interested in finding out what is in store in future. So we'll look at that also. But first, I'll be very happy if somebody can guess the area of life where this event happened. And let us use Vimshottari Dasha, Narayan Dasha, and Tithi Pravesha, the techniques that we have learned so far. First, let us use Narayan Dasha, because that's what we've been learning for the last couple of classes, last class. So let us see Narayan Dasha. Okay? So what Narayan Dasha is he running? He's running Aries Narayan Dasha. And the Antardasha that he's running right now is Pisces. Now, in Aries Dasha, how will be Pisces Antardasha?
First of all,
he's running Aries Dasha. So, first of all, did the Dasha start from Lagna or 7th house?
Lagna.
It started from? See, Pisces. The first Antardasha was, the first Dasha was Pisces. So, it started from Lagna itself, not from the 7th house. So, take Aries itself as the Lagna. Now, if you take Aries as Lagna, how is Pisces placed?
12th house. Well, 12th house of losses. And the sun in there, sun of course in Manakar.
Sun is in Manakarka Sthana, in that house. What house does sun own?
Sun owns the 6th house, no, 5th house.
He owns. Does everybody follow Sriram's analysis so far?
Yeah.
What he said is, he's running Aries Dasha now. And in Pisces Antardasha, the results of the 12th house and results of sun will be given. And he is saying that sun is in Manakarka Sthana. If you remember, for sun, 12th house is Manakarka Sthana. For moon, 8th house. For Mars, 7th house. For Mercury, 7th house. For Jupiter, 3rd house. For Venus, 6th house. Saturn, 1st house. Rahu, 9th house. These are the Manakarka Sthana. So sun is in Manakarka Sthana. When sun is in Manakarka Sthana, houses owned by sun will be destroyed. So what houses are there? It is the fifth house of children, fifth house of abilities. So do you expect that there will be some problem relating to children or abilities during this Antardasha?
Yes.
Possible. Yeah. So that Manakarka Sthana was a good point. And now, do you want to see the Dasha Pravesha Chakra?
Yes. And do you also want to see the Progress Lagna?
Progress Lagna is Aries. So we did this analysis from Aries. And how is the Lord of Pisces? We didn't see that.
Right, Jupiter.
Pisces is 12th house, but its Lord is in 7th house. So what kind of events can the Lord give? 7th house events. Can he give marriage? Yeah. Of course, this person is married and he has a child also. Can he give a new job? Can he give a job, good job?
7th
is actually, is it good for job or is it bad for job?
It's bad because it actually is a karma, a desire. So you're promoting
business.
And also it's marka for 6th house. From the 6th house, 7th is the 2nd house of Marka Sthana. So 7th house can give a business, or if somebody is in service, it can bring the end of service. So that is what the 7th house is capable of doing. Sun is also karaka for career. And not only 5th lord of abilities, but he's karaka for service. Yes. And he's in the 12th house in Manakarka Sthana, and its dispositor Jupiter is in the 2nd from the house of service. So do you think that there is some possibility of
losing the job?
Yeah. Let us see the entry chart now. Because compared to the natal analysis, the entry analysis is always clear. That is what I found in my practice. If you see more examples, you will see that entry chart will shed light more clearly than the natal chart itself. So if you look at the entry chart, what is the possibility? What are the possibilities for Pisces, Antardasha?
Aries.
No, in Aries Dasha, this chart is for Aries Dasha. This entry chart is valid for all the 12 Antardasha. We want to, in particular, judge the Pisces Antardasha. What are the influences on Pisces?
Venus, Sun.
Yeah.
Third house.
Is the third house?
Venus is exalted.
Venus is exalted. Venus is he a good planet or bad planet, Venus?
He is the lord of fifth house and he is the lord of...
Venus is the lord of fifth house and the lord of
tenth
house.
Good.
So fifth house is abilities, recognition of abilities, and tenth house is
career.
So such a planet, the lord of those two important houses, he is in Pisces. So there can be important events relating to career, relating to recognition of abilities during Pisces Antardasa because of Venus. But is Venus happy there? Or
oh.
Is he well placed there? Or is he badly placed?
Combust.
Earlier, do you remember the analogy I gave you for this combustion of Venus? When Venus and Sun are together, I gave you a Puranic story. Do you remember in the beginning, first few classes? In the avatars of Vishnu, who does Sun represent?
Sri Rama.
Who does Venus represent in the avatars, according to Parashara? Parashurama. When Parashurama and Rama were together, what happened?
Rama won and Parashurama won.
Parashurama gave all his power to Rama and he withdrew. So similarly, whenever you see Venus and Sun together in any chart, Venus will lose all his power. He will become powerless to do anything and Sun will become powerful. Sun's agenda, Sun is like the king and Venus is like dancing girl. Whenever dancing girl is with Sun, basically whatever Sun wants will happen, whether it is good or bad. Now, what is Sun's agenda? Venus has a good agenda, but he becomes powerless to follow that agenda, to pursue that agenda. Whose agenda is followed now? Sun's. And what is it? Good agenda or bad agenda? Sun is the eighth lord.
Mm-hmm. Making work hard,
unexpected results, etc. So he, the eighth lord, had he been alone in third house, it would have been good. Without Venus, if Sun was alone in Pisces, eighth lord in third is a Vipris Rajyoga. The Sthana lord in another bad house. It would have been a good placement. It would have been very good. But unfortunately, the Sun joins Venus. So what is the end result? Venus, whatever Venus stands for, there will be some disappointment relating to that area. So either relating to children or relating to career. So do you think that So looking at both the
charts.
Analysis based on natal chart and based on energy chart.
So actually, that's how when the planet is combust, like Venus has withdrawn its power. So it's not able to manage both the fifth house and tenth house responsibility.
Yes.
That means it'll neglect it. Is that what's going to happen or what is the actual analogy to it?
If the planet is just combust, that is it is exactly as you said. The person will not be able to put energy in those particular areas. So you need to strengthen that particular planet. Pardon me?
Check the sahims of the children and also work.
Yes. Saham of children as well as kari. You can look at the karma sahamam. That will show kari.
Yeah.
But we'll go into sahamams later because the rest of the people don't really use them that much. But the point that I was trying to make is if Venus was just combust, it would have been bad. Whatever Venus stands for, the chance of that being pursued is very less. But here, Venus is not only combust, but he is afflicted by the 8th Lord.
Oh.
The 10th Lord is afflicted by 8th Lord. Forget Sun and Venus. Even if it was other planets, some other planets. If the 10th Lord is afflicted by the 8th Lord, there can be some shock in career. There can be some disappointment in career during that time.
As is.
So now there are two negative indications mixed here. Venus, the 10th Lord, is afflicted by the 8th Lord Sun and he is also combust so that he is powerless. So a powerless Venus is being
tortured
by the 8th Lord. And do you remember the name I gave for 8th Lord? I said that 8th Lord is called Khara. In any divisional chart, if you look at the 8th Lord, actually the exact definition is, if you look at the 8th house cusp, let's say somebody was born in Virgo Lagna, at 2 degrees Virgo, let us say. Then if you go to 2 degrees Aries, that is the exact cusp of the 8th house. So if you take that point, and where that point falls in various divisional charts, the lord of that particular place is called Kharesha, or the Lord Khara, basically. That's the translation. Khara is, he's one of the chiefs of army in Ravana's army. He's one of the army commanders in Ravana's army. So basically, and literally it means mischievous. Khara literally means mischievous. So the lord of the Kharasthana, he always gives some shock or the other. That is his agenda. So this Venus is not only powerless because of combustion, but he is joining Khara. So because of it, there can be some disappointment relating to 5th or 10th house. Okay. Now, we want to see Vimshottami Dasha also.
It should also give him some image, good image, right? Arda Lagna is there.
One second. Yes, it is. Yeah? Yes.
Arda Lagna.
Yes,
Arda Lagna
is there.
And
yes.
Some image
post. But, right. There, some changes also, because Sun is the 8th Lord. If 8th Lord is in Arda Lagna, you can expect that there will be some changes in the image during that particular time, changes in the status. There will be up and down.
Could be
negative, could be positive.
Because the 8th house is again, generally, shocks, anxiety.
Right. But the thing is, Sun is placed in a friendly house there.
Yes, Sun is strong.
Sun is in a friendly house, Jupiter. So even if the 8th Lord, 8th is not really a malefic house, it's a neutral house. So if the 8th Lord is in a friendly house in Arda Lagna, usually there can be some changes in image. But the final image will be good only. It can't totally destroy the image. So even if disappointments come, the image will not suffer greatly. That is the general result. If Sun is in Pisces,
good maybe. Karaka for image. Anyway.
Yes, exactly. If Shani is in Arda Lagna, it's a different matter. Basically, you have the image of being a Shani. That's a different matter. But if you have the image of being a king, it's fine. So Sun in Arda Lagna is fine. And there is actually another thing. We focused on Pisces. But focus on Jupiter also, the Lord also. Because the sign itself shows the circumstances, the situations you have to face. And the Lord will show how you face them. Because Lord is the consciousness. He is the intelligence. Like I keep saying, signs are circumstances and situations. They are inanimate. But the planets are animate. They have life force in them. So the attitude with which you cope with whatever circumstances you have to face, that attitude, it has a life. It is due to the consciousness within you. So you have to see that from the Lord of the sign, not the sign itself. So Jupiter, is he well-placed or badly placed? Jupiter is well-placed. He is in a corner. He is in the 9th house. And especially for Jupiter, being in 9th house is good. Because he is karaka for 9th house. So during this antardasha, yes?
So Jupiter in 9th house and 8th Lord being powerful there, will it also give him reason occult sciences?
Yes, absolutely. Yes. It will give a lot of interest in occult sciences, and especially because of Jupiter in the 9th house.
Right.
He will get good guidance. His intelligence will get good guidance during this particular antardasha. His progress in astrology, as far as his progress in astrology is concerned, he would have made a lot of progress in this particular antardasha.
But provided he started learning astrology.
It doesn't have to be astrology. It can be some other traditional subject. But Jupiter in the 9th house and 8th Lord being in Pisces means that either occult knowledge or any traditional knowledge, any classical knowledge. Yes. If he tried to learn it, this is a very good period for him. And I believe Vikram started taking serious interest in SJC California's activities in the San Jose area. I think those guys are getting together some weekends and trying to learn. So he may have indeed made some progress, but that's a good point. And will he cope with this tragedy? There was a tragedy in his life. Will he cope with it well? Yeah, because Jupiter, the Lord of the house, he shows how he copes with it. And that planet is well placed, giving that case of yoga. So he will cope with it very well.
But he's also with moon.
Yeah, what is bad with
it? Influence on his mind and thinking.
Yeah, if Moon is with Jupiter, that is good. If Moon is with Rahu, then there is affliction. Moon with Saturn or Rahu, then Moon is affected. But with Jupiter, he is happy. Jupiter is the one who says, don't worry, everything will be fine. That is Jupiter's attitude. Everything will be resolved, don't worry. So that is the influence on his mind. So he has, there is certain level of calmness during this whole, we are talking about this whole antardasha. If you focus, maybe during this week, he's very perturbed, but maybe within a couple of weeks, he will regain his balance. You will see that when you go into Sthiti Pravesh and focus on each week or each month. But looking at the antardasha itself, the whole 1 year period, during this period, he'll be very level-headed, very balanced.
But we haven't
point out from this class that what if the event occurred, right?
But we have some idea now, right?
Right.
We have an idea. We will confirm it as we look at more factors.
So this chart will not pinpoint.
No.
We had to go to the position chart to pinpoint that.
Yes. But this does show that during this whole 1 year period, some big disappointment in career or relating to children or relating to recognition of abilities is possible. So that we have concluded. During this whole 1 year, when does it happen? Does it happen during this week or does it happen during that week or this month or that month? That is tough to see from Narayan Dasa. Unless you go to Pratyanta Dasa, Sushwanta Dasa, etc. But like I told you, don't do that right now. Just focus on Dasa, Anta Dasa. 1 year resolution is good enough. You want to see important events basically. That is how we will use Narayan Dasa. So for that we will go to Vimshottari Dasa first. First of all, what is the dasha we should use? What is the nakshatra dasha? Is it Vimshottari or something else?
69, Sun is in the Lagna.
Right? Yes, Sun is in Lagna, so? 69 dasha? Good. Anybody for something else? Yeah? Even what? Moon is absolutely strong, yes. So Vimshottari dasha will also give good results. Now, I'll give you a choice. What dasha do you want to use? Okay, good.
He's very strong.
Moon is very strong, yes. Okay. Now.
Thank you, resources.
Now, he is running. At the time of the event, he is running Moon, Mars, Sun. Who wants to take a shot at it? How will be Moon Dasa, which has been running since 1999 and it will run for a few more days? How is the Moon Dasa?
It's good for it. It's fifth house law. It's on fifth house.
Yeah.
Lot of fifth house in the second.
Lot of fifth house. Okay. Okay. You are still looking at Rashi chart.
Rashi chart.
Okay. But let us go to Dashamsa because we are concerned about career. Let us see if there is any event in career. Okay.
You want to jump to Dashamsa? It could be the children or with the career.
Okay. Right. It can be both.
Why don't we narrow down from the Rashi before we go?
Very good. Let us see Saptamsa and Dashamsa. In the Saptamsa, how is Moon Dasa?
Is a lot of the seventh house sitting in the fifth house of abilities.
Yeah.
Which is afflicted with Rahu.
Yeah.
So it will affect his seventh house and his fifth
house. Yeah, he's afflicted by Rahu.
Right.
But the seventh lord, Moon, and the ninth lord, Mercury, are joining in the fifth house. So there is a Rajyoga relating to children during this part. So during Moon Dasha, because there is a Rajyoga relating to children, do you think that during this dasha, if he didn't have children earlier, he will get children?
Yes.
Overall, there will be happiness relating to children.
Yes. Or what does the affliction of Rahu mean?
Can it show that there will be some anxiety, some tension relating to the birth of child?
I think so.
There were some complications when they had a child. Because if you look at the first child, it is shown by Mercury here. First child and second child, actually both are shown by Mercury and Moon, who are affected by Rahu. So, with that, there will be some anxiety relating to the birth of child. Things will not happen smoothly, right?
And he's the Lagna Lord, so he won't do
the... Who is Lagna Lord?
No,
Rahu. Why? No. Rahu owns only Aquarius, not Capricorn. Saturn has two houses, Capricorn and Aquarius. He decided to share only one of them with Rahu. If you say that Rahu has the other one also, that is Kabja Karnana. Okay. So,
Rahu
is capable of doing that.
That's exactly what he goes for. He grabs everything he can.
Rahu, yeah.
No, eclipse, we have to see the closeness and the degrees, right?
Then what eclipse?
How badly afflicted, it will depend upon how close you are. Look at the moon degree, 4 degrees Aries, and Rahu. Rahu is how many degrees?
Okay, actually degrees. This is... The degrees that you are seeing right here are the D7 degrees. Especially those. In D7, each Saptamsa is around 4 degrees, some minutes long. So So that is basically that window has been expanded to 30 degrees. So you will see numbers from 0 to 30, but basically it shows whether it is towards the end of the sign or the beginning of the sign. So I chose the longitude in D7, and Rahu is at 27 degrees and Moon is at 2 degrees.
Oh, they're very close. 27 is 2 degrees.
No, no, they are far away.
Extreme.
They are extreme. One is at the beginning.
Thinking about the other process where you would do 30 minus.
Yeah. Okay. And actually, Mercury is badly affected by Rahu. So the birth of the first child, there will be some problem. There will be a lot of anxiety. And I believe he went through some anxiety. There were some complications in the birth of child. I believe he went through some anxiety. But it does, based on the chart, it does show that the birth of the first child will have some severe anxiety. Even the birth of second child will be accompanied by some anxiety. Because Moon, even though he is at the other end of the sign, he is still with Rahu. So still there is that eclipse effect. But Mercury is more afflicted than Moon. Anyway, coming back to the current Antardasha and the current Dasha, current Prachandardasha. How is Sun Prachandardasha in Mars Antardasha? What kind of results will it give?
The Paka and Goga applies even if you go...
Yes, it does. So if you look at Mars Antardasha and Sun Prachandardasha in it, take count from Mars to Sun. From Mars to Sun, it is the fifth house. From Sun, if you count the fifth house, it is Gemini. So the Bhoga in Mars Antardasha, Sun Prachandardasha, Bhoga is in Gemini. So what is experienced is Gemini. Is it good or bad? It's a sixth house. It's not a good house. Venus is in Madhukarka Sthana there. So there are some negative indications. There can be some bad event relating to children also. More importantly, Sun. He is the eighth lord.
Eighth lord in second house is the marker for the first house itself. So the existence itself has some.
Yeah. So it's a bad Antardasha. It's a bad Prachandardasha. Now let us go to Kerit.
Kerit, you see Mars and Sun. Sun is Mercury and Sun together.
Yes, Mercury and Sun, there is a Budhaditya Yoga. In case you are interested, Sun is in Yamamsa, Mars is in Anantamsa, Moon is in Agniyamsa. These are the Amsas. Okay, so both Mercury and Sun, both are in Yamamsa. Okay, remember that. Yeah, Mars is Atmakarta. Now, let me restart the recording. Okay.
So the Bhoga in this case is falling in the seventh house of the sun.
Bhoga is?
In the seventh house. Because you take
Mars. Bhoga is in the seventh house. Did everybody get that?
Yeah.
Or was Sriram just too quick?
Now, can we go from the Mahadasha and what's in the...
Okay. The Mahadasha, overall Moon Mahadasha, will it be good or bad?
Good, because he's in Lagna.
He is exalted in Lagna. So, it should show. For me? No. First we are judging how the Mahadasha is. And then we are seeing how the current period is.
So why is it Moon?
It was always Moon, even in the other case. Because we are looking at Shashyani Dasha, because Sun is in Lagna, in the Rashi chart, we are looking at Shashyani Dasha. And when you click the Dasha, right now it is Moon Mahadasha. Till February 11th, it is Moon Mahadasha. That is the name. So, Moon is exalted in Lagna, so he shows good spirit. And from Arudha Lagna, because that is important for status. From Arudha Lagna, he is in the ninth house. The ninth house is basically protection.
So his Arudha Lagna, Arudha is very well protected.
Arudha is well protected by exalted moon. So during this whole 6-year period, this whole Mahadasha is a very good dasha for Kerit. His status will be very good during this particular Mahadasha. But there can be ups and downs based on Antardasha and Prachandardasha. What about Mars?
Will it think Venus different by any chance this whole Mahadasha? Because it's
actually this Parivartana.
Yes, there is a Parivartana. There is a Parivartana between Moon and Venus. But again, both are good. One is in the... So, Moon will act as if he is basically placed in the 11th house of gains from Arudha Lagna. So again, both of them are good planets. The 9th lord, from Arulagna, one is the ninth lord, one is the 11th lord, and they are exchanging houses. So it's a very good placement. Yeah, but Rahu is not that bad here. He is the 10th lord.
He is the lord of the 10th, from Lagna.
So it's not that bad. So overall, this Maharasa is a good Maharasa. And if you want to see what are the possible results during these 2 months, we want to focus on these 2 months.
Correct.
When the bad event happened. If you want to do that, now look at Sun. From Mars, if you look at Sun's bhoga, where is it? Mars is in the ninth house here in Ketukan. From him, Sun is in the sixth house. Count the six from Sun. It is
the seventh house.
So the bhoga is seventh house. What does seventh house stand for in the samsara?
Last of
sixth house is service.
Correct.
Seventh house is, it can be last of service or it can be business. So during this time, starting a business is possible, or it can be some loss of job. He may have been laid off or something. So those are the possibilities. So that is the bhoga. Now let us look at Tithi Pravesha. So, looking at the Vimshottari and Narayandasa, we see that there are problems possible in both
children
area and career area. Both of them are still standing out. Now, let us look at the current annual chart. 2004. If you make the 2004 annual chart, the previous chart, the data is March 22, 2004, 2:54:32 a.m. At the location of the birthday. Now, let us look at this particular year. Who is the ruler of the year? Who is the Hora Lord?
Mars
is the Hora Lord. Okay? Mars is the ruler of the year. And now let us look at Tithi Ashtavatri Dasa. What Dasa has he been running when he had this problem?
Venus.
He is running. For me? Last Tuesday, he said, in the mail. So the mail was sent a couple of days back, so it must be this Tuesday. Was it 25th? Yeah, 25th. So the event, I think, happened on 25th or maybe 1 week back, but definitely in this.
Venus
Maharasa. Now, is Venus Maharasa a good Maharasa or a bad Maharasa?
So the children, Venus, fourth house of debilitated Venus.
Let us see the Rashi. Let us go to Rashi chart. In the Rashi chart, is Venus a good planet or a bad planet?
It's afflicted with Rahu's fifth house, the lord of the sixth house, and the...
Does he have a parivartana?
Venus has a parivartana with Mars.
Yeah. Venus and Mars have a parivartana. So, Venus has an exchange in the annual chart with who? With the ruler of the year, with the lord of the year. So, whatever lot of the year shows, those events can be given during this Venus Maharasa. So, something very important, the event of the year is possible during Venus Dasa, or it could be Mars Dasa also. One of the two Dasas can give that result. Now, is it a good Parivartana or a bad Parivartana? Is it a good Yoga or Duryoga, this Parivartana? Pardon me? Why is it Duryoga?
Because Rahu is a lot of the third house.
Forget Rahu now. Rahu is also there, complicating it. But forget that there is Rahu there. Just look at Venus and Mars. Fifth lord and sixth lord exchanging. Is it good or bad?
Bad. But the agenda of the sixth house that is...
Yes. Basically, they have totally different agendas. One has a very benefic agenda, one has a very malefic agenda. Each being told to do the job of the other just confuses. It's not a good thing to have. If you see any parivartana between Dusthanas and Kendras, or Dusthanas and Konas, let's say Duryoga. On the other hand, if you see a parivartana between a Kendra lord and a Kona lord, is it good or bad? Suppose, for example, what example can I give? Let's say Leo was the Lagna, not Sagittarius. With the same chart, let us say Leo was the Lagna. Then is Venus Mars parivartana good or bad?
Good, because
then it's a parivartana between
9th and 10th houses.
That would have been good. Even though Venus and Mars are not good friends, they are not the greatest friends. They don't like each other. So still, a Rajyoga between Venus and Mars is not as powerful as a Rajyoga between, let's say, Moon and Mars, or Moon and Jupiter, or Mars and Jupiter. That Rajyoga is not that strong. They are enemies. They are forced to work together to get something done. They will do it, but not happily. So that Rajayoga will be weak. And here, but at least it will be good to some extent. Here, not only are they enemies, but one is sixth lord, one is fifth lord. Fifth is basically 12th from sixth. So one planet shows abilities and recognition for it, and one planet shows
killing
of the recognition and having to work hard because there is no recognition. So those are the two agendas. And they are exchanging their houses and in Dvaraka from each other. So because of that, the result that you expect in the Venus Dasa, will it be good or bad?
It will be bad.
And what can it relate to? Because Arush Lagna is there, it can relate to the status, it can, and fifth house is involved, it can relate to enemies, job,
and children.
And of course children. And of course recognition of abilities. So we haven't really narrowed down further. We are still in the same quagmire. Whatever we found in Narayan Dasa using the Antardasa, we could not rule out in Vishwati Dasa. We could not rule out even here. That is interesting. Now let us look at Saptamsa. In the Saptamsa, the fifth lord is Venus. And he is placed in the 12th from it. The 12th from the 5th house, and he is debilitated. He is in Nicha. Right?
Yes.
So Venus Dasa, is it good for children or can there be some anxiety relating to children? Hospitalization of children or ill health of children. 12th
house is
Dushthana. 12th house is Dushthana. Lagna Lord is in 12th house. It shows some kind of bandhana. It shows some kind of disease, some kind of hospitalization or some ill health.
No,
I'm taking the child now.
Oh, okay.
If I take the first child, that is the fifth house.
The fifth house, which is child, the lord of the fifth house, is Venus. Nietzsche is in the fourth house.
So there can be some anxiety related with children also. Okay? And I don't know, actually the answer that he gave on the Yahoo group for the puzzle does not have to do with children. It has to do with career. So we will focus on the career, but looking at all the indications, even with the health of the child, health of his child, there may have been some anxiety. That's what I feel from the chart. I will ask for his feedback and I'll let you know in the next class. But let us focus on Dasamsa now, because the event is not, the event that he gave as a devastating puzzle, is not, devastating event puzzle, is not relating to Saptamsa. Now Dasamsa. What is Venus showing in the Dasamsa?
He's
the second lord and the ninth lord. So he's a functional benefic. He's not a malefic. He doesn't have any bad agenda. But where is he placed? He's in the third house. Is it a good placement for a benefic? For Sun, Mars, Rahu, Ketu, third house is a good placement. For Venus, it's an average placement. It's not a great placement. And in particular, I don't know if you remember, what is the, in Dasamsa, I gave you a special meaning of third house. Third and seventh. Third and eighth, actually. I told you that third and eighth can bring certain kind of changes in career. Does anybody remember? Which is long break? Third is short break. And eighth is long break. So, especially in Dasamsa, third house shows a short break. Like going on a vacation for a period of 3 weeks. Are being out of job for 3 weeks. If you are a contractor and you are on the bench, you are looking for a new placement and you waited, let's say, 1.5 months. So that would be planet in the third house. So planets in the third house will give a short break in career. It will not be too long. It will just be a short break. On the other hand, planets in the eighth house, they give a long break. Somebody can take a 1 year break and go to India, go to Himalayas, do something and come back. So that will be shown by eighth lord. Or the 8th house can also show retirement. If a planet is in the 8th house in Dasamsa, in the annual chart, and his Dasa is running, he can retire. Of course, you don't make a prediction on retirement just based on Siddhi Pravesh, but it is a possibility. But in any case, if somebody is looking for a job, if somebody is just laid off and he is looking for a job, he comes and asks you, and you see that the planet is in the 8th house, then you should be less hopeful. You should give him more serious mantras, because the indications are not that great. But here, Venus in the third house, Does everybody agree that there can be a short break in career? Yeah. Now, what about the status? Is Venus a good planet for status or a bad planet? Why is it bad? How do you see status? The status in career, professional status. Aruha Lagna. So if you look at Aruha Lagna, Venus is in the 12th house. Venus in the 12th is not good. It shows loss of image, loss of status.
But he is the lord of the 11th house.
Yeah.
Okay.
When you see the lost ships from, don't look from Aruha Lagna. See the lost ships from Lagna.
Only.
Yeah.
So when you look from Aruha Lagna, you just look at the planetary position.
Where the planet is.
So don't look at the
Lost ship. So Venus, he shows basically the fortune. He shows the money. Second house and ninth house. He shows the resourcefulness and he shows the fortune of the person. And those two will be basically lost during this time. Not lost, but they will seem to be lost. Because Aruha Lagna is what seems, what people perceive. So people perceive him as somebody who lost Venus, who lost his resources, who lost his fortune, and who lost his guidance, who lost his past basically. So overall, Venus dasa is not a good dasa.
Also, age 7 in 12th from air, that gives some information?
No. It's not good, but let's not read too much into it. Now, does anybody want to make any prognostications? Actually, we have consolidated the prediction.
Yeah.
What is the prediction?
I'd say he lost his job, pretty much.
He lost his job, okay.
Well, we don't know that it's short, but it's last Tuesday, so...
Yeah.
So based on the third house, we can say that
it will be a short break. Based on the third house, we can say that it will be a short break. It will not be a long two-year sort of job kind of situation. We can say that it will be a short break. That is what we can say. And should we conclude that this was something that resulted in a fall in his status, fall in his image, or it is just a regular layoff?
According to the prediction, yes. He lost his image. His image came out.
And his sixth lord, both the lords are in second house, which means he has a lot of resources to come back or something like that.
Yes.
Right?
He is very resourceful. He will be very resourceful during this year. That's what you can say based on this.
What is he saying that because of...
His point is, see, if you want to see when he will get a job or how he will do his job, look at second house, sixth house and tenth house. So these are the three houses, right?
Yeah.
Right? So his point is sixth lord, Saturn and Rahu are in the second house. So he's saying that second house and sixth house are very strong. He's very resourceful in overcoming obstacles. That's what he's saying. Especially Shani is strong there. But sixth lord being strong is not really desirable. But it's an Arthasikona. So he will have basically, he will be busy.
He'll work hard. Thing.
Yeah, he will work hard, he'll be busy.
Will make him work very hard.
Now, dashas. Now, actually, is Rahu under dasha? Was Rahu dasha good for him? Let us see the background. He said that something was cooking for
couple of weeks.
The last few weeks. But so, towards the end of Rahu, especially Rahu, is a very interesting period. The first week of January, and in general from the last week of November, December and the first week of January, that is Rahu Dasa. How is Rahu Maha Dasa? Is it a good Dasa or a bad Dasa?
Sixth lord.
Yeah, he is the sixth lord in the second house. Yeah, he is the sixth lord. Rahu will give whose result? Will Rahu give his own results or somebody else's results? Rahu and Shani are together. So Rahu will give Shani's result. And Shani is the exalted sixth lord joining Rahu. Shani is the exalted sixth lord who joins Rahu.
But he's also exalted fifth lord.
Yes, he's exalted fifth lord. Exalted sixth lord. But because we are talking about Rahu and Shani exchanging results, and Rahu has an interest in the sixth house, he will make Saturn act more like the sixth lord rather than fifth lord. So Shani will act more like the exalted sixth lord. So is that good or bad? Exaltation of sixth lord, is it good or bad? I told you earlier. Debilitation of sixth lord is good. It's part of Jayoga. On the other hand, exaltation of the sixth lord is bad. It shows you have to work against some obstacles.
Some places I read, like maybe it's wrong, but they say that sixth lord being strong, he can any cases or anything against him, like he can be victorious in any cases. Is that true?
That's not exactly true. Sixth Lord being strong basically means he will have to fight a lot of cases.
Okay.
That's what it means. And he will fight. He will not give up, basically. Because the Sixth Lord is strong, he will keep fighting. But it's not really a good combination. If you have Sixth Lord debilitated, it's always a blessing. Then victory will come very easily. Sixth Lord is exalted, then also victory can come. But it will come after
a lot of fight.
You have to fight for it if the Sixth Lord is strong. Sixth Lord weak means you get things without fighting. It happens very easily. That's the meaning. And here, so Saturn and Rahu combination here will mean that during the Rahu Mahadasa there will be some enemies. Will his enemies, assuming that he has some enemies at his workplace, will they be successful? Will they be strong during this period? Or will they be weak?
Enemies. Sixth Lord. Basically, in the 60s
enemies. Yeah, 60s enemies. So because Sixth Lord is strong, his enemy, it's a good period for his enemies. And because Shani and Rahu are involved, will his enemies resort to very nice means? Or will they resort to harsh means?
Harsh,
crude, mean, selfish. And Rahu can also show scheming, machinations kind of. So there will be some scheming. Can you conclude that before this event in Venus Mahadasa, in the previous Rahu Mahadasa, there will be some scheming against him by his enemy?
He didn't perceive it till the beginning of Venus, because it's 2 weeks from last Tuesday.
Right.
So, but the background work has been happening even before he perceived.
Must have happened in Rahu Mahadasa, especially Rahu. January 1st to January 6th is the period when Rahu would have basically raised his head and
said, we got to chop.
The enemy basically did all his planning and all his scheming during that time. I will ask him for more information, for feedback on whether that particular week was indeed an important week. But that's what we would expect based on the chart. And now let's look at the future. So there was some scheming against him, and he was let go. He was fired from his job. Now, how will be the next dasha?
Sun in general should be good because he's the fifth.
Because he's sun?
No. Then he's the sixth house.
First tell me one thing. First, look at Rahi chart. Because Rahi is his physical existence.
Gotcha.
If he doesn't have a job to go to, and if he is worried, when will I get a job, it should be seen in Rahi chart also. Because physically, he is uneasy. He is restless. He is basically not feeling good. So, Rahi chart is your physical existence. Dashanta is the professional environment where you are working. So, before we see further results from the Dashanta, let us see the Rahi chart also. In the Rahi chart, is Sun a good planet or a bad planet?
Good planet, because in a lot of the ninth house.
Yeah. Yes. Ninth. He has a Parivartana. Is the Parivartana a good Parivartana or bad Parivartana?
Good Parivartana.
Yes.
House Lord and ninth
the
house
fourth Lord Jupiter and the ninth Lord Sun have a Parivartana. So that's a very good Parivartana. It's a Rajyoga. And then Sun will act as if he is Jupiter there.
Yeah.
So there is a Rajyoga between Gajgesari Yoga, indirect Gajgesari Yoga, there is also a Rajyoga between Jupiter and Mercury, the Lagna Lord and the tenth Lord. And before the Parivartana, Sun is the ninth Lord and Mercury is the tenth Lord. So ninth and tenth Lords are together. So there is Dharma Karmasa Yoga also. But because of the Parivartana, that will not give results to the fullest. The results will be more of Mercury, Jupiter, Rajyoga. So, but the eighth Lord Moon is also there. Whenever you see a Rajyoga where the eighth Lord is also associated, the Rajyoga is weakened. The Rajyoga will fructify in a very uncertain environment, in a very changing kind of environment. There will be a lot of unexpected results, there will be a lot of anxiety. So it will happen amid anxiety and amid tension. So that's what you can say. But overall, it's a good, definitely Sun is involved in good yoga compared to Venus, who was engaged in the stupid Parivartana with the king of the year, with the ruler of the year. So that was the problem. So Venus is very bad, but on the other hand, Sun is very well placed. So do you think that Sun Dasha, I mean, God forbid, let's not say that he will not get job until Sun Dasha starts, but we will come back to that later. We will look at the next few weeks. We will put the microscope on Venus Dasha and see. But let us assume that Venus Dasha is not a successful Dasha. Then when Sun Dasha comes, do you think he will get a job?
Yeah, I think 9th house, 11th, 4th house. I think he'll get it.
Okay, so Rashi wise, physically,
okay,
his tensions will be less. He will be less tense. There will be some positive events relating to physical existence. But to see the professional environment, go to Dashamsa now. Is son well placed in the Dashamsa?
He's a lot of the 12th house, but he's in the 5th house. 5th house is good. The 12th house is...
To get a job, what is the house I mentioned earlier? 2nd, 6th and 10th shows what kind of job you get.
Okay.
That is the work. But to first get land a job, you have to be recognized. 10th
yeah.
house is to do something. To that is karma. Doing something comes after you get a job. First you have to get a job. How do you get a job? Somebody recognizes you. Somebody sees your resume. He thinks you are good.
A5.
So, A5, yes. A5 and also 5th house. And the 5th house from Arut Lakna. So basically, look at the 5th house. The planets in 5th house in Dashamsa have a good chance of bringing a job.
Jupiter is in Nitya.
Yeah. Yes, Jupiter is in Nitya with Sun. Basically, Sun, as far as career is concerned, Sun will give the results of
Jupiter.
Sun will give the result of Jupiter. And Jupiter, though he is in Nitya, he is basically the Lord of Arut Lakna. And he is the Lord of Labhapada. Labhapada shows tangible gains in career. And
A10.
A10 is Karmapada. It is Rajapada. So it shows the tangible work that you are doing. This is the tangible work that you are doing and this is the tangible
gain
you are making. This is your salary basically. A11 is your salary or any profit that you are making. So that is what is coming to you. So A11 and A10, the lord of those houses and also the lord of the house of status, that planet Jupiter is in the 5th house. And Sun will end up giving his results because they are together, they will exchange their results. So Sun will give good results. But at the same time, there is debilitation.
Sun is not well placed.
Yeah, Jupiter is actually. Jupiter is in Nisha. And because Sun is giving his results, Jupiter's results, during Sun Dasha, you will get some results of some Nisha placement of Jupiter during this particular Dasha. So what
Sun
can...
Is having Parivartana or what?
No, he is with Jupiter. If you remember, not only Parivartana, but when there are two or more planets in the same house, they will exchange each other's results. They will end up giving each other's results, right? Okay? Now.
But they are in the captain's house, so they are not.
They are not?
Well, like for example, for Sun,
yeah.
Captain's house is not good place. I mean,
for neither.
Neither.
Jupiter also. For both Jupiter and Sun, for both of them, Saturn's house is not a good house. So, whatever opportunity comes, may not be a great opportunity. Because which house it is shows what kind of circumstances. So it may come under some negative circumstances. And Jupiter is in Nitya. So there may be some satisfaction also.
Maybe he will get a job of lesser salary or something for time being.
Yes.
Because Saturn is wrong. It has to be, of course, Saturn is very strong, but
because it's debilitated, maybe he'll accept something of lesser salary.
Yes. If he gets some job in Sandasa, you can expect that there will be some lowering of his status. There will be some disappointment associated with it. It may not be the perfect job for him, or he may not be making as much money as he would otherwise make. There will be some undesirable factor associated with his job.
The lord of the 12th house can not make
sense. Yes, that is the other factor. Sun is the lord of 12th house. What does 12th house stand for? So Sun's agenda is 12th house. What does 12th house stand for?
Loss
or giving up. Settling for something less. That is also 12th house. 12th house theoretically is the losses house, the house of losses, Vyaya Bhava. But it can also show giving up something. I may be voluntarily giving up my career to do something else. Somebody voluntarily resigned so that he can focus on something else. So that is also 12th house. Or somebody voluntarily settled for a lesser job. That is also 12th house. So 12th house is some kind of settlement, some kind of adjustment, some kind of loss. So that is Sun's agenda. So overall, you can expect that in March, when Sandasha starts, Sun Sithya Stotri Dasha starts, March 21, assuming that he did not get a job until then, he should definitely get a job after March 21, before April 11, and it may not be the best job for him.
The fact that, as you said, the house represents the environment.
Yeah.
The Saturn, which is a lot of that house, is exalted. That means What does exalted Saturn mean? It's something which is a monotonous, laborious job.
Saturn will show, Saturn and Capricorn will show routine jobs.
Routine jobs.
Routine jobs are jobs where you have to work hard. But the Saturn is exalted, their dispositor is exalted. So what that means is that working hard will come easily. He will have to work hard, but he will work hard happily. He likes it, basically.
He likes it.
During this year, he likes working hard. And he will be made to work hard. So it's both ways. Now, in Venus Dasha itself, is there a chance that he will land a job? Is there a chance that he will land a job in Venus Dasha itself?
On second house is resources.
Just give me your honest view.
Seventh, ninth house. It is possible because if you look at it, it's a lot of the ninth house, Venus is, and it's a lot of the second house.
Uh-huh.
So ninth house protection could help, couldn't it?
Yes, ninth house. He's the lord of ninth house, so he gives some protection, some bhagya.
Some bhagya.
Yeah. But look at the current Antardasha. The Antardasha he is running right now is Mercury. Is it a good Antardasha or a bad Antardasha?
Mercury is the lord of 10th house.
Yeah.
The Boga is part and he is in the 10th house.
Okay. Yeah. Mercury is a very good planet.
Right.
Mercury is the 10th lord in the 10th house. He is the Lagna lord. He is giving Bhadra Mahapurusha Yoga. So as such Mercury is a good planet. But if you look at the
results of Boga,
yeah.
Venus to Mercury, that is 8th house.
Venus to Mercury is 8th house. From Mercury, if you count the 8th house, it is
5th
house of recognition. So in Venus Dasha, Mercury Antar Dasha, there is a chance of getting some recognition. So before February 6th, in the next few days, actually there is a chance that he will either land a job or somebody will call him. Somebody else that he worked for before or somebody who knows him, he will give him a call. He will look at his resume and say, oh, these guys let you go. Why don't you come here? So something like that is definitely possible in Mercury Antardasha itself. How about Saturn?
Saturn is a lot of the 5th house. It's a great situation. But look at Boga.
Boga is falling in Lagna.
Boga is falling in Lagna. And he's in the 12th house from Dasha Lord in the Samsa.
Yeah.
So it's not bad, but it's not that good. So basically, in the next 2 weeks itself, there may be he may be able to make some headway in getting a job. But whether that actually fructifies or not, whether he gets a job or not, I'm not really sure. I'm not fully confident. If I have to make a prediction without any bias, my prediction would be that in Venus Dasha, something may come up. Especially Venus is in the third house. So some kind of contract kind of position may come up. The planets in the third house, they not only show short break, they also show contract position, short-term kind of placement. So during this year, during the remaining Venus Mahadasa, before March 21, he may land another job or he may land a contract, but something more permanent, something more stable is possible in the next Mahadasa of Sun. How will be the next year for him? Because something so important happened in his life, such a bad event happened, and he is towards the end of the year, because in March, April, his birthday will come again. So let us quickly see how will be the next year for this gentleman.
But Allah is Sun.
His next year data is April 9, 2005, 11:32:15 PM, and the location is the same as birth. The Hora Lord is Sun. The Hora Lord is Sun. And look at the Rashi first. Okay, before going into division, look at the Rashi chart. Sun is the
Lord of the 10th house.
Lord of the 10th house. And is he well placed or badly placed?
He is afflicted
with Rahu, he is afflicted by Rahu, he is afflicted by Mercury, but he is with Venus.
Exalted Venus, but still.
Yeah, exalted Venus. So overall, he has his share of
pain.
Who is afflicting him closely? Okay, longitude is still in Kapsamsa. Let me change it back to Rashi. Okay. Sun is at 26 degrees in Pisces. Mercury is at 8 degrees, Venus is at 28 degrees, Rahu is at 29 degrees.
Close.
Okay, so Venus and Rahu are very closely with Sun.
Do you take Rahu's degree as it is? Or
Yeah, as it is. No, for both Rahu and Ketu, when you see where they are, how closely they are reflecting planets, they will accept you if they are close to you.
Yes, I've seen some places where they were subtracting.
Yes, because
that is to see the advancement in the science.
Mm-hmm.
When you see the charakarakas,
because it moves in the opposite direction.
When you see the charakarakas, if you want to see how advanced Rahu is, even though he's at 29 degrees, because he's coming from back, he has advanced only by 1 degree, actually 51 minutes. So he has the least advancement out of all the planets. That is why you will see that he is Dharakaraka. Atmadharaka is Venus, who is at 28 degrees 30 minutes. He is the one who advanced the most in the sign. So when you are looking at how advanced he is in his sign, then you count from the behind. But when you see how close he is to troubling somebody, see, let's say some sun is moving from that corner of the room, he is coming. And Rahu is moving from this corner and he's coming. If they are at the same point right now, Rahu can hit Sun, right? Because he is close to Sun. So that is what matters. It doesn't matter from where he has come.
What happens in this case is Venus can get numbers with Sun, right?
Yes.
And
Venus is weak. Venus is extremely weak.
No, but Sun is totally eclipsed by Rahu, which is the case in this case.
Mm-hmm.
Sun is himself weak, so how can he make Venus weak?
Very good point. Very good point.
Right.
So what do you think? What do you guys think?
I think Rahu.
Sun, Venus and Rahu are together. So what is the final judgment of the result?
I think Venus is strong. Because of the effect of both Sun and Rahu. Because Venus also has...
Does Rahu make Venus weak?
No.
Rahu and Venus are great friends.
Guru is very strong.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Venus is basically the teacher of the demon. And Rahu is his favorite demon student. And Sun is, he's basically like a king. He's Aditya. So, whenever the teacher of demons goes to the Deva, goes to the God, he's basically hammered. But this time he took his best student.
And let him do something.
And especially this best student, he hates Sun. He eclipses Sun. So what is the end result?
But Venus is strong, very strong.
Venus is strong. Yes. And Venus can show materialistic results as well as spiritual results. And because he is with Rahu here, the materialistic side of Venus will dominate. And that will basically have its impact on Sun.
But he is also in Pisces, so the spiritual side of his dog can also show.
But he is with Rahu. He's so closely affected by Rahu.
And his seventh lord.
And had he been very closely with Ketu, it would have been different. But if a planet is strongly with Rahu, then Rahu is always taking towards Bhogamarga and Ketu is always taking towards Mokshamarga. So Venus will be impacted by Rahu.
But aspect doesn't matter here?
No. When you are so closely with somebody else who is in India and calling you and telling you what to do, it doesn't matter. The planet in the seventh house is like somebody who's on the other end of the globe. So they can influence you, but the one who you are sitting with right now in the room, he will clearly dominate. But apart from it, coming back to our basic analysis, Sun is the tenth lord. He is extremely well placed in the fifth house, but he is very badly afflicted. Okay? Now, who can help Sun fight the eclipse, fight the affliction? I told you earlier, when Jupiter is afflicted by Rahu, it is Sun who can help him. When Sun is afflicted by Rahu, it is Jupiter who can help him. Because when a bad demon comes and starts fighting with the devas, with the gods, it is the teacher of the gods who comes up with something brilliant. He will tell his favorite student, who is a god, how to fight. That's not affliction. Ketu is not affliction for Jupiter. Rahu is affliction. Jupiter is happy there. So Rahu and Ketu are like two demons. Rahu is bad demon, Ketu is good demon. So when the bad demon went for fight, Jupiter took the good demon to him and he came and told him, do this. And then together they are going to influence everybody. So even though Sun is afflicted by Venus and Rahu, it's not that bad because all of them are in Jupiter's house. The landlord of the house where they are living is Jupiter. And that Jupiter, he's aspecting all of them. Where is Jupiter? He's in the 20th degree of Virgo. So, and Sun is in the 27th degree. So within 7 degrees, Jupiter is aspecting Sun. So there is actually a Rajyoga between them. Sun is the 10th lord, Jupiter is the 5th lord. When 5th lord and 10th lord are aspecting each other, it's a Rajyoga. It's a very good yoga for Kerry. So during this year, there will be some machinations. There will be some scheming against him.
Yes.
Yeah. There may be something similar to what happened this year. Or it may be a continuation. Who knows? I can't really say that for sure. But there will be some schemes against him in his new job. But this time, he will succeed. Because Sun is the ruler of the year. Not only is there a Rajyoga. When you see a Rajyoga and one of the planets giving the Rajyoga being the ruler of the year, that will dominate during that year. When will it happen? When will? After some disappointments or after some trouble, after some anxiety, he will be victorious and he will get good recognition in his career during either during Sandasa or during Jupiter Dasa. So during March, April time frame, when is the date? Okay, this is basically, this Sandasa is only for 2 days. Even though it shows from March 23, the actual date is?
Well, it will be a piece of it towards the end of it.
Yeah, April 9. So most of it is over
by the time you get
by the time the year started. So it's only a couple of days. So either during April 9 to 11 or during September 21 to November 23 or towards the end of the year, after March 12 next year. During that time, there will be some very good developments in his career. He will be recognized very well.
In this case here, just you know, an analysis here, because you're doing Rashi.
Yeah.
The Rahu and Venus and Mercury, they're supposed to signify personalities of people in physical life that will affect them. So does it mean that somebody like in the office that he worked with, there will be somebody like Rahu and Venus and Mercury that will affect him or deal with him?
Yes, that's quite possible. Yes,
it is possible.
Yes. Okay. So what is your prognostication? Does he have something to worry? Does he have a big long-term problem? Or do you think that his problem will be solved very soon?
His
problem is very likely to be solved very soon. And this is likely to be a very short break. And he will redeem himself in the next year. And there is a nice Rajyoga in the next year. So actually next year will be a good year. Even though an anxious year, it will be a very good year for his career. There will be some good developments either in September, October, November time frame or next month.
There's still pain in the whole process.
Yes, there is. But there is a clear yoga that dominates.
It's a pleasurable pain.
Yeah. It's a play. No, not a pleasurable pain. Pain is never pleasurable. It's a pain that's worth it. It's a pain that's worth it. Because at the end he will win.
And it is in the night to Ardha Lagna, so it will give protection to his image.
Yeah. How will be his studies in astrology during this year?
Also, if I look at Rahu Dasa, first of all, there's going to be a loss of image. That's going to be severe.
Yeah, Rahu Dasa will be bad because 9th from
Ardha.
Okay, one second. What Rahu Dasa are you talking about?
We're looking at the analysis of the period of Rashi. Ardha Lagna is in Cancer.
Yeah.
To say 9th from that is where Sun is positioned, which is a lot of this thing.
No, it will protect anything in the 9th from
Ardha Lagna. Planets in the 9th from Ardha Lagna tend to protect the status. Protect the image. So again, all these nonsense that is going on in Pisces,
it still protect.
It will not be detrimental to the
image.
If any planet is in the 9th from Ardha Lagna, it is unlikely to spoil your image.
Because the protection.
Unless he happens to be 8th lord. For example, take Mercury. He is actually the 8th lord from Lagna. So he being in the 9th from Ardha Lagna, he will tend to break the image. So when Mercury gives his results, which will be in Uchitasa, how do you see? Mercury's results will be given in? Actually, that is another thing that we haven't taken into account. Yeah.
So Venus is the best. Venus is the most benefit.
Venus, Mercury, Sun and Rahu.
So that means Mercury and Sun will exchange.
So whatever good results are promised by Sun will actually be given by Mercury. Yes. And in Sandasa, he will get Mercury's results, which are not actually good. So, Mercury's
results are not good. The previous time we said that Sandasa, actually, it will not give the Sun results.
Yes. But this is at the physical level. We are talking about the physical level. If you want to talk about the career, then go to the Samsa.
Sun
is good in the Samsa. Pardon me?
From 6th house.
Yeah. Sixth lord of Sarvi. sun in the Aruh Lagna. So we are looking at the Dashamsa of the annual Tithi Pravesh chart. In this chart, sun is the sixth lord of service, so he does not show business or anything. Sixth house is clearly strong, so this year there will be service only, and the sun is in the Aruh Lagna. So there will be a good image. The only problem is sun is in Manakarkasthana from his own house. The sixth lord sun is in Manakarkasthana from his own house. So it will not be a smooth year, but overall there will not be any harm to the image. But it's unlikely to be a smooth year.
And his boss will protect
him. But the nice thing is he will have a good boss who will protect him. Why?
Jupiter
is in the 9th house, 10th lord in 9th house. Not only 10th lord, Lagna lord is in the 9th house, Jupiter. 9th lord is in Lagna, Mars. So between Lagna and 9th house, there is a Parivartana, Mars and Jupiter. That's a great Rajyoga. It's a Lakshmi Yoga. It shows good attachment between him and his boss. He will be good to his boss will be good to him, and the boss will protect him. That is the most important thing. That's why we always say 9th house is the most important house. Because if you are looking at career, having a good boss is the most important thing. If you have a good boss, you are all set. Whatever else is happening in the workplace, it doesn't really matter. He will take good care of you. So that is the blessing. Because of Jupiter in the 9th house, and having a Parivartana with a friend, if Jupiter is giving Rajyoga with Saturn, it will not be that great. It will be good, but not that great. But if Jupiter and Mars are getting together to give a Rajyoga, it's always very, very positive. So, actually, if he asks you later during the year, if he says that something is going on at my company, there is going to be a layoff, how will my boss take good care of him? You can tell him, your boss will keep your interest at the topmost of his mind. Especially in Mars period and Jupiter period, Mars and Jupiter period, his boss will be very positive towards him and he will gain because of it. So overall, it's a good year for him. There is some anxiety, but it's a good year for him. So God bless Vikram. He's a nice person. I met him personally once when I went to one of the workshops in California. He's a very nice person. Now, let us go back to the annual chart. Let us see the Narayan Dasha. We only saw the current Antardasha to explain the event. So whatever we saw in Tithi Pravesha, basically next year not being done bad, let's corroborate that using Narayan Dasha, because we are learning Narayan Dasha now. He is going to start Leo Dasha soon, on April 7, 2005. How will be Leo Dasha?
It is all revolving around sun.
Yes. It's all revolving around sun. Now, first of all, let us not go to the Dasha Pravesha Chakra and look at individual Antardasha. Focus on the whole Dasha. How will be these 5 years? What is the main change in his nature? What kind of a person will he be? First take Leo in Lagna. That is activated. Whatever planet is there, whatever house it is, that will be activated.
Ketu
is getting activated. So will he become more spiritual? Very likely. And it is the sixth house. Because it is the sixth house, job will be very important during this time. There will be a lot of events relating to job.
A10
is there. That's good. So A10 shows things that have been accomplished in the career. These are the accomplishments in career. So there will be some good accomplishments that he can remember later. So it's a good
also have the mental tension throughout
this period. Because it is the sixth house, there will be some obstacles or the other that he has to overcome during this period.
So the planet in that sixth house is Ketu, is ninth house planet, and the sixth house planet is in the Lagna. I don't see it's a bad.
Sixth house planet in Lagna is actually bad. For sixth house planet being in third or 11th is good, or in our sixth house. Sixth house planet being in Lagna means all the obstacles basically sitting on his head, influencing his head directly, influencing his brain directly.
Both are bad.
If you have a Parivartana, that's a very bad Parivartana. So that is a good point. But your other point is right. Ketu being in the sixth house is good. Even though it is an inimical house, for Ketu, sixth is one of the only three houses that are good. 3, 6 and 11. These are the houses that are good. So because he is in the sixth house, he is well placed. So overall, this is a good Dasha, but there will be a lot of obstacles that he will be overcoming. And Now let us take Leo as Lagna. If you take Leo as Lagna, what can you say?
8th house, the sun, of course.
Lagna Lord, sun is in the 8th house. Mm-hmm. So that means, again, he will be working hard. Lagna Lord in 8th means you will be willingly working hard. You will be a karma yogi, basically. If a Lagna Lord never harms you. Lagna Lord is the most important planet in the chart. His agenda is Lagna. Lagna is your very existence, your health, your integrity, your peace, everything. Your entire existence is Lagna. Lagna Lord's agenda is that. So he does not want to harm that. But still, he's in the 8th house. That means you will be willingly working hard. So that will make you a karma yogi. So during this period, he will be like a karma yogi. He will be working hard. And there is a big conjunction of planets in the 9th house. So things relating to dharma will take an important role in his life during this particular Mahadasa. So there will be a lot of events relating to dharma. And Jupiter is not well placed. Yeah. Jupiter is in the 3rd house in Manakarkasthana. And he is the 5th lord and 8th lord. So 8th is good. Any debts that he has, they can suddenly disappear in one day for some reason. So that is good. 8th lord in Manakarkasthana is very good. But 5th lord is in Manakarkasthana. So he has to be cautious about his child and abilities. Yeah. So 5th house also, 5th house can also show so many things. Can show, for example, your uncles. Some people say 6th house, some people say 5th house. Both are there. But there are so many things that the 5th house stands for. But Jupiter is Karaka for children also. He is the 5th lord and he is Karaka for children. So he has to be careful with children. There can be some bad events relating to children during this period, children's health, etc. He has to be very careful about that. But looking at the entry chart, let us focus on the next 1 year. The same year, see 2005 April to September is Aries Antardasa, and September to February is Taurus Antardasa, and then Gemini Antardasa. So let us focus on these three Antardasa. How will be these Antardasa? So, Aries is the second house.
Resources.
Aries is the second house of resources, and where is the Lord?
Good, 11th
house. He is exalted in the 11th house. So it's very good. Aries Antardasa is a very good Antardasa. He will have a lot of resources, he will make a lot of money, he will gain, he will keep that money, he will not waste that money away. So it's a very good Antardasa. So September, April to September 2005 is a good period. And what about the next one, Taurus? Taurus is the third house, and its Lord Venus is exalted in Lagna with all these afflictions. So nothing really stands out. It's not a great period, or it's not a bad
period. Similar to what we talked about. Yeah. Oh, Sun and Mars. Are no, Mercury. Venus is very strong in Lagna.
Venus is
very strong in Lagna.
Similar. Venus is very strong in Lagna.
Yeah.
Combination there.
Rahu.
Yes. Sisi Pravesh basically happened close to the Sadhaka Vasu Pravesh. That's why you see the same influence. Right. But the Lagna is different. So now, during the Taurus Antardasa, it is the third house, and third lord is in Lagna. So he'll be communicating a lot. Third house is communication. He'll be very optimistic during this period. And he'll be writing a lot at his workplace. Maybe there is a lot of writing that he has to do, a lot of documentation. So that is what Taurus Antardasa has in store. What about the Gemini Antardasa? The Lord is in Lagna. And Saturn is there.
And they're both friends, of course.
There will be some discomfort.
But basically, you don't detect any important event.
Yeah.
Look at the Antardasa, see things that stand out. For example, 2nd and 9th, their Lord is exalted. So Aries, Scorpio and Capricorn, these Antardasas are likely to give good results, lot of gains, lot of material gains, etc. Jupiter and Ketu are in Virgo. When that Antardasa comes, definitely he will become more spiritual, he will learn more astrology, all those good things will happen because Jupiter is Lagna Lord, Ketu is 9th Lord. Also Jupiter is 10th Lord. So Jupiter Ketu are giving Dharma Karma Adhipati Yoga. Ninth Lord Ketu and Tenth Lord Jupiter are together in the seventh house of desire.
Correct.
So there is a Dharma Karma Adhipati Yoga in the house of desire. So he wants to do good karma, perhaps relating to Ketu or Jupiter areas, which can be astrology, it can be Vedic knowledge, it can be any traditional knowledge, anything relating to Vedas, because Ketu stands for Vedas and Jupiter stands for Vedanta and traditional knowledge. So during Vargo Antardasha, see, if you want to judge each Antardasha using this technique, you can judge, but it's not, there's no point. You want to use this technique to identify the years when something important will happen. So financially, this is a very good period, and spiritually, 2007 May to 2007 October, that is a very good period. Based on Narayan Dasha, we can conclude that during that period, some important event will happen in his astrological life. He's also an astrologer, but he's not a very advanced astrologer. He's very seriously interested, and he's organizing a group that learns astrology in California, in San Jose. And you can expect that during that period, some very good karma will happen from him. He is just trying to do some great karma in the society relating to astrology or relating to any Vedic knowledge. 2007. Now, if you are looking at a real chart and if you want to make predictions to a real person, always corroborate a finding using two techniques. So using Narayan Dasha, we found that 2007, May to October, is a very glorious period from the point of view of astrological activities. Now let us see the annual chart of that year. Make 2007 Tithi Pravesha chart. Okay? Who's the ruler of the year?
Mercury.
The ruler of the year is? Mercury. He is the Hora Lord. Where is he placed in Rashi chart? What houses does he own? Sixth house and ninth house. Ninth house of Dharma is one of the houses that are covered. And he is in the second house with Rahu, second Lord Rahu. If Mercury is associated with the second house, is it good for astrological learning and astrological activities? Yes. We said earlier that Mercury and Jupiter in the second house is good for prediction. And he is with Rahu. In the who is the second Lord? So that shows lot of intuitive predictions. So during this year, Mercury being the ruler of the year means that he will make some good predictions. And Rahu there means that they may not be based on solid principles, but they may be based on
intuition.
Rahu and Ketu will give good intuition. And especially Rahu is very strong there. He is in his own house. So during this year, he will make some good predictions and bring good name to astrology. Good name to the organization that he belongs to. He will make some very good predictions during this year. Let us see the Dashamsha. How is the Dashamsha during this year?
Lord Mercury is in the 8th house. He's not in...
So Mercury is the Lord of the year. He is the Lagna and?
And the 10th Lord.
10th Lord. He is with the 11th Lord Moon and 8th Lord Mars in the 8th house. So 8th house really, really stands out in this particular year, Dashamsha. So he will do some karma. Why I say good karma? Because Moon and Mercury are there. Mercury is basically the Lagna Lord. So his agenda is never detrimental to his career. It will be a good agenda. If Lagna Lord is in the 8th house, you can conclude that there will be good activities, good hard work relating to 8th house matters. So 8th house in Dashamsha can show occult activities in society. And there are Mars and Mercury there. So he will be very active in terms of astrological activities around him in the society during that particular year. And where are Jupiter and Ketu, the planets that we saw in the Narayan Dasha?
In the 7th house.
They are in the 7th house again. Just like in the Dasha Pravesh Chakra. So that is repeating. So that means there will be strong desires relating to Jupiter and Ketu. There will be, during this year, all his public activities shown by Dashamsha will be governed by a desire to spread Vedic wisdom. Jupiter, Ketu is Vedic, Jupiter is wisdom. Jupiter and Ketu together is Vedic wisdom. So there is a strong desire relating to those areas. And also 8th house of occult activities has a nice Grahakuta. So 7th and 8th are really standing out. So we don't want to see how his job will be during that year. That is secondary. That is of secondary interest. That's not how we came into this chart. We came because of Jupiter and Ketu in the Narayan Dasha Pravesh Chakra. So that is corroborated by the Tithi Pravesh Chakra. So you can make a prediction that during this year, 2007-2008, he will become very active astrologically in society. He will make good predictions. He will be organizing a lot of events for Sri Jagannath Center, and he will do some good karma during that year. That will be a very important year for him. Like this, you can look at the Narayan Dasa entry chart for each Dasa and judge the Antar Dasa. So what I want you to do is take your own example. Take some important events, look at the Narayan Dasa, look at the entry chart, see if you can make sense. If you cannot make sense, bring the example. Bring the example, the data and the event data to the next class, and we will all together go through your example. Okay? So in the next class, we will continue some more Narayan Dasa examples. With that, I will end for today. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.